Hello. I hope you can hear me all right. I am half. Sorry if there's any lagging or anything. I don't need this right now, but I've been setting stuff up. My streaming machine is having some technical difficulties at the moment. Because Windows, basically, and I can't figure out what processes are actually eating away the CPU, the RAM, and the disk. Mostly just because it's like Windows system stuff, so it doesn't tell me what specifically it is, and if I disable it completely, Windows just shuts down. But it seems to be running background processes way too much right now. OneDrive would not stop refreshing and trying to update. A virus scan was taking up a lot of the system resources, like scanning the drive, but then when it finished, the drive usage never dropped back off again. So I'm gonna try a few more things later. In the meantime, though, I did say that I'd be back this week, so I wanted to come back this week. A lot of unexpected stuff ended up coming up. I have a medical appointment tomorrow. I've been out of town a couple of times. My health has not been the greatest. It's been doing new weird things, which is... Anyway, I thought, at the very least, I tried to fix the cameras a bit, and I may have fixed my counter down here. I might have fixed this. It was real messed up, and then I couldn't get it to actually accept my information, or the information I was putting into it. It kept just pretending it was the sample one. So I've reset that again, so the counts accurate. You can see that I've fixed my overlays again. I've tried some more permanent measures to fixing the color correction, everything with the cameras. One of the issues I'm having is that I have to film in very low light. So, I mean, it's probably about as bright as it looks to you on screen. Or a little dimmer than that, slightly, but one of the main reasons why I start to feel like I need to get off stream, like, now, is because the lights are too much. And because I can't have bright lights on me for very long, I end up struggling with film quality. Sorry. Some of you are probably familiar with the idea that even if you have, like, a really good camera, if the lighting quality is bad, it can't pick up, like, very good color information, so the, quality ends up seeming, like, grainy and pixely and less than it could be. The other problem that I have with bright lights is that my skin becomes just, like, a white shining mess. Like, brighter than that wall. It's just, my skin really reflects light. So there's that. This is what I have for right now. I'll keep trying to tweak it. I have been working on my lighting setup, just trying to have more lights with, like, a lot of diffusion on them so that I can back off of boosting the brightness digitally. And I've had to switch over to doing it in OBS as, like, a filter rather than having it be in the camera settings, because the cameras keep resetting every single time they get unplugged, and they have to be unplugged because if I don't, they won't register, like, a new picture. They're, like, frozen, basically, until I unplug them and de-reactivate them. So, I didn't manage to get the thing, where is it, the popsicle sticks cut yet, but I wanted to go over this. I'm hoping you can see this. Anyway, this is going to be the plan. For whatever you can read, you might be able to tell I'm completely losing my voice. I've made some decisions about like how each of the little decks that come off of it are going to be shaped, how the popsicle sticks need to be cut and arranged, how many I'm going to need. I'm going to do the corners more like this, in between the decks, because there's going to be here. We'll switch cameras for a hot second. I'm going to bring this up, which I also set up. I'm gonna direct your attention this way. There is going to be a balcony off the front and off each of the sides so that I can make stuff leading up to the front of the house and stuff on the sides of the house and have it be supported. It's not gonna come out that far, but I didn't like the idea of having, just square chunks missing out of the corner, and I wanted a lot of flower box, so I decided that in those corners, I'm gonna do some angled things like this. Sorry about that, and I'm sorry if it's loud in the mic. But yeah, and like, gosh, I've misplaced everything. I was going to come to this stream so set up, either at this desk with half of it cleared off, or at another table that I have with a second project on reserve to move to. But I have had a really unexpectedly complicated week. Dear Lord, that's an alarm. Why? It needs to stop. That's an alarm for me to water my plants. But yeah, lots going on. But I did want to show you this. I actually found some hexagonal pre-cut pieces of wood, smaller ones, a little smaller than this, and then larger ones, and I thought they'd actually make this whole project a lot easier. I found them at the dollar store. They're like $1.25 or something, so I picked them up. But otherwise, mostly I just have a plan of how many popsicle sticks I need to cut in what ways, including doing framing for these windows. So I'm going to go over that with you once I actually have them cut. This did get dry. So we're gonna just take this out and see what we have and try not to destroy the mold too much. So we have this little clay hexagonal pile, and I figure we should be able to sand it down to be more even, and trying to keep some of the organic quality about it, especially on the front. Make sure it's really a perfect hexagon and that, they'll tile together nicely. And then I'm gonna make a silicone mold of this. Probably about four times, as I was saying, and then we'll be able to make tiles for the front. Mostly what I wanted you here for today was I wanted to get some varnish on these bricks. What can I? I'm just gonna bring this, oops, up a little closer to the camera. I wanted you to see it just because it's kind of satisfying to watch. And I was going to use a Tamiya gloss that I have, but here. There we go. But I couldn't find it, and I pr primarily bought it for ball jointed doll making. So I'm actually going to use this like quick dry glossy top coat. Very carefully on each brick. I also didn't want to risk getting residue of anything in the Tamiya gloss. And the reason why I'm tapping it here is to make sure it's actually getting into the surface texture of the brick and to actually keep it from being too shiny when it dries. But when I gloss them, you might be able to tell better with this really nice one over here. It kind of gets rid of that dusty look about them that I couldn't completely get rid of from cleaning the excess grout out from between the bricks. So when I put the varnish on, it brings them up to like this really like deep saturation of color, and you get to see what they actually look like. And I thought that might actually be a fairly satisfying and non-boring part of this process to watch, really. So and I didn't want to not update just because I didn't get a chance to slice up those popsicle sticks. I needed to move around this morning for medical reasons. I just needed to be up and moving around. And so I ended up dragging out the component parts of my greenhouse and putting them together into a temporary plant rack, or two large ones in my kitchen. I kind of like this set because it's a lot like grown-up Legos. It's just got bars and joiners and little mesh shelves. I've been putting pictures on Instagram. Oops. Oh, the wood's a little varnished. Both of what I've been doing with my plants, getting my garden started for the year, and also the intermediate steps of doing up these bricks. In case anyone wanted to see a step-by-step, and so that I didn't have to make anyone sit through me cleaning these off with a toothbrush. There we go. Those are coming up nice and shiny. And as you can see from the ones that I did ahead of time, they're staying like that when they dry. I kind of actually came to a decision about these this corner piece here. It actually ended up being the only thing that's kind of wonky because of the outside angle of the house, because I managed to get the rest sitting pretty good. So I'm probably actually going to add moss or vines or something to that portion. That was kind of always in the plan to decorate this afterwards with like lots of moss and plants and just make it look really busy and full of life. And so I decided that I'm just gonna cover the spots on the bricks that I don't like with some plants, and that the intense green of it will stand out really nicely against the brick, so I don't have to worry about that one ugly spot. Because it's not ugly, but it kind of looks a little extra janky, a little too much character there, maybe. Maybe it also kind of creates a natural little alcove that plants would like to grow in, like moss or lichen of some kind. We have some kinds of lichen that like to grow around here, if you know where to look for them. Mostly on decaying wood that almost seem to have like bright orange flowers, just because like the little tips of their growth has some orange colony of something that's part of the biome of the lichen. And that looks really pretty. I want to avoid getting too much of it in the road in between, because I like it the color that it is, actually. And I'm trying to sort of tap it until it's sort of really sticky so that it's taking away some of that super glossy finish before it has a chance to harden all the way. which it's doing pretty quickly because these are dry absorbent surfaces and this is quick dry glossy nail polish. But really just want to get it into that surface texture and have it bring out all of the depth and the shading and have the holes not just be full of the light colored dust from this. And some of it's still going to be in there, but because of the way the varnish soaks right into it, it turns it really dark. So it doesn't look out of place for it to be in all those little holes. And of course, next time I will try to have as much of the woodworking ready to do as possible. Because after we get all of that put together and glued up, the next step will be getting to mostly do some finishing steps and then like decorate it, like put on all the little details, put the door on, finish up lots of stuff. And then we'll be, well, actually after the wood, I think the main next step is going to be, this is a little hard to get to, is going to be the lighting inside of it and the windows. So, or at least the lighting for the windows, and then the windows will come sort of near the end of the woodworking, I suppose. A little bit on there. Also, some of the foundation did break off, and I'm going to have to re-sculpt it once I even find the clay that it was made out of. And I mean, it'll basically just be a repeat of what I did before. And the, I'm still getting used to the size of that camera. I completely forgot my sentence. My spine hurts. God, I can't even back up and see what I just said. Oh, this is a disaster. Oh, what's it called? The thing. Something. We're gonna be doing lighting, woodworking, windows. Want to get the wood all ready. Want to do something super funky with the windows. No idea what I was about to say. Yeah. But I did do a lot of gardening this morning, so. Oh yeah, okay, so there are some little shell things, the fossils, that was the word I was looking for. Some of them broke out of the foundation, but I found teeny, teeny, tiny little seashells. What I'm probably going to do, since I have to paint the foundation now anyways, because of having to glue it back together, I'm probably going to glue in some of the teeny, tiny little shells. And that, like, even drill out places to set them in properly. So that's probably gonna look pretty cool. I don't usually do shorter streams just because it kind of ruins my stats. I only tend to get, 3 average views when real-life. The varnish on this one, the nail polish, really try to get it in there because I don't think it's taking to the didn't really take the surface texture very well. The trick here is to try to get enough nail polish into the surface of it without just soaking the brick in nail polish. And without letting any of it, like, dry before I can get the surface fully worked. Some of these already look a little shiny because they were, like, brushed over dry or just barely damp with the toothbrush a lot. that kind of shined them up. So yeah, we'll make lots. We will start making lots of progress on this at some point. Like as things that we're preparing start to fall together, and I actually finish up this brickwork, and I do plan to get back to you with more prepared on a stream, because I don't tend to get 3 average viewers as a minimum on short streams, and I'd like to keep my stats up, so once there's 50 of you, we can get a nice subscribe button. Yay. So that'd be nice. I am saving up for a better computer system to mostly use for, video game design. I should probably put this in makers and crafting now that we've gotten going on the bricks. I'm sorry about that. There we go. We'll change that up. I did the thing. I did fix a lot with OBS. And one of the things that I tried to do was get myself real familiar with the inbuilt chatbot system that I didn't know was there until Wish told me it was. So you can thank Wish for me knowing how to do that now. I mean, I would have found it. I just didn't know to look in the program, and probably would have taken a lot longer without someone telling me where to go to set that stuff up. Just really trying to get rid of the look of the lighter dried clay in there. A little bit of it isn't bad, because that's just more a surface detail, but yeah, we're starting to, one brick at a time, we're starting to see that come to like a full, rich color and finish. One of the bricks on the front blew a bubble after the polish dried. And that kind of looked a little funky. I had to scratch it off because, I mean, it shouldn't be there. The bricks shouldn't look varnished, but looked kind of nifty. The next fairy house type thing I make is going to have a lot of like beach glass and like seashells and stuff, so I'm looking forward to that. I did, while I was out of town, not only find chicken wire that I can use with my plants this summer, but I also found a couple of kind of thrifty antique-y throwaway things that I could use to make new lampshades for the lamps that I'm designing. Both of them sort of themed after the Myst video games, and those will be crafting projects more in the vein of like this that we'll get to at some point. I'm not even sure this brick really needs that, but we'll just, yeah, it still makes the color a lot richer, and you're starting to be able to see like the brown and the yellow and the red that was brushed onto them better than you could before. So I made these two kind of elaborate plant shelves out of the greenhouse kit that I have. It's like a $300 one. Like, I saved up for that. Half of that cost was freaking shipping. And now at least I have an opportunity to use it. I have started probably any crop you could name, at least some iteration of it. Got like rutabagas. Guess I haven't planted any potatoes yet, but I'll end up doing that throughout the year as our potatoes grow eyes, or grow too many eyes. got corn, sunflowers, carrots. I haven't done the beans yet because I only have one planter of peas right now. And I'll be putting more of those in throughout the year, especially in a hot minute after I get a little bit more potting soil. But last frost isn't until the 22nd of next month this year, and I am not happy about that. My plants are not happy about that. And nobody's having a good time. Our growing season's threatening to be barely over 100 days. So that's gonna be fun. We might get 120, and if we have a stupidly late, unpredictable fall again, like we did a few years back, we might actually get like a full 180 days or something. Like one October here, it was still freaking summer. Not too many years ago. But it seems to have been the exception instead of the new rule, and now it's approaching mid-April and it's snowing right now. Like, I look out my window and, oh hey look, it's snowing. Ass butt. So that's fun. First year that I really am allowed to properly garden by my landlords, and our growing season is gonna barely be like 100 days probably. So that's why I'm starting everything inside now. Got a little trays of seedlings. Two things have come up so far. The pickling cucumbers, the tiny boy cucumbers, and the beefsteak tomatoes. A few herbs. There's a few little sprouts just curling out of the ground for everything else. But at least once the sprouts are out, they are taking off. And really, I planted these things like a week ago. They have no business being as developed as they are right now, the things that have sprouted. Like, I expect the rest of these to take a while because they're supposed to. Don't know what these boys are doing, but they're having a good time, so whatever. I might give you a tour of the garden the next time I am in the kitchen with you. I did get more cream cheese, but I don't have new cooking pans yet, so I may or may not make cheesecake. But we'll see if some of the bots I set up come on. Seem to at least have the Hydra bot working. If the bots I put together don't come on, I probably just need to type the command in the chat while I'm actually streaming. Yeah. I forgot to go get my other cushions. My back's kind of already mad about this. I was going to spend more time preparing for streams, as I said, but in addition to everything being kind of wonky lately, my roommates also decided now is a good time to just clean the house. Nothing's really defrosted, but it did get a little warmer here, and I feel like it's had the spring cleaning bug sort of bite them. But a lot of the stuff that has to be done is stuff that is just kind of, stuff that I take care of. So, that and dishes, which my one roommate helps me with a lot. But I've been a little busy just resting and trying to get that stuff done and then resting more. I would like to get to designing my new bullet journal soon. and I would like to do that with you guys. I already have some ideas. I know I want it to look like a book. I know I'm going to do the outside of it with thin wood and wood glue and some thick ass twine so that when I put the pleather or leather on it, the spine ends up looking like one of those really old antique books that's sort of held together with thick cord that way. But I also had to figure out how to kind of make the front of the book out of three separate panels because of the way the pleather I have to work with is sort of cut up, divided. Sorry. So I decided I kind of want to make it look like the Myst book, you know, where there's sort of like a border where the color that's on the spine comes around, like it comes in a little ways, and then with like corners so that I can just like more easily find a piece that's appropriately sized to fill in the middle. I'd like it to be teal. This shouldn't be on its side. I kind of like the teal colors I have in here. So that it matches my goggles and my book bag. And then also a dark mottled brown, which is the main pleather fabric that I'm going to be using for it, which is the leather I used to make the back strap of this. So, there's that coming up at some point very slowly. There's all the silicone crafting that I was talking about, probably definitely in the next month, I'd say. I don't like promising things within a week because I have a hard time with my health a lot. But try to get to it in the month for sure. I'm kind of relieved that I just sort of found this opportunity to get like my gardening work done at least a couple of days early enough in the year, because usually I struggle to be ready for spring and I have a hard time getting things in the ground on time. Especially because right away, first thing in the spring is when a lot of my health issues shift from like one issue to another. Like, because it's getting warmer, instead of being too cold and losing circulation all the time, suddenly I'm starting to get too warm and have my blood pressure crash all the time. So instead of struggling with circulation to my fingers and toes, I'm suddenly struggling with circulation to my brain. That's a fun little yearly transition. And the magnesium is not helping. It is outright crashing my blood pressure, especially now that it's starting to warm up a little. So I'm gonna have to draw back even harder on taking it and really talk to my specialist about that. Because she might have the same condition as me, at least one of a few conditions I have, but she does not seem to get super low crashing blood pressure like I do because of it, and if she gets low blood pressure at all, it is definitely not to the same extent, because magnesium acts as a muscle relaxant in a lot of ways. And all muscle relaxants lower your blood pressure. So I don't even know why she told me to take it, as I've probably said previously, because the main complaint I went in for last time is my blood pressure is so low that I can't sit up without being dizzy and needing to lay back down, and I can't stand up without blacking out, and I keep being involuntarily unconscious and missed appointments because of it. So she tells me to take something that she should know lowers your blood pressure. But I've entertained it. I gave it a good try. And now I have to try to get another appointment before this next summer causes me to start having heart attacks or something. So that's fun. Sorry. But I am super excited about having a garden because I haven't really been able to before. My last landlord only begrudgingly allowed for it, and sort of forced me to put it in a corner of the yard that got absolutely no sun at all, and thus everything rotted and died. And also her soil's horrible because she insists on mowing the grass so obsessively that it doesn't get a chance to grow, and then she wonders why it's dead. But she also, like, rakes up all of the leaves and doesn't compost them or anything, or let them rot under the snow during winter. So the soil is just stupidly depleted because the property is full of trees. So the soil quality is just gone and nothing can grow there. But she didn't want to let me do very much gardening work because she was worried about the curb appeal. So, the place before that, the landlord was basically like, do whatever you want, like, fix this place up. But then it almost became an entitled to me fixing that place up and constantly hounding me about when I was going to do this or that, all for free and on my dollar, of course. So, that didn't work out. But, and also I broke my foot, like, the first major year I started trying to really, like, farm in the backyard, I, smashed my foot checking on a bird's nest and falling sort of around a ladder in an enclosed space when the safety on the ladder failed and sort of dropped me. And I was wearing, like platform boots because they were the only boots that I had that I could go into the attic with because it was like full of insulation and unfinished. So I like twisted my foot under me when I landed, like around a ladder inside a closet where the attic door was, and got a twisted fracture on one of the bones inside my foot. They're like, we don't know how you did this. This is a really rare kind of fracture to have, and like in the middle of your foot, like, what did you do? And then I explained, and they're like, oh, that would be why. That would be how. Because my foot twisted under me in 4-inch heels, without me being able to maneuver to like take the impact off of my feet or like roll properly or anything after falling a full story feet first is how that happened. So that kind of put a halt on the gardening plans that year. So now I have landlords that are like, yeah, have a garden patch back here. This is where we used to have ours. The soil is really good. And you know, plant all the flowers you want in the boxes around the property, and you can decide what plant you want to put around the foundation. And so that's really cool. They seem not only enthusiastic about having the property when they lived here, but they also seem enthusiastic about people who live on the property enjoying it. And getting to love it as their own home. So that's really cool. And I already have a lot of the gardening supplies that I need from previous years. I just need more potting soil. And probably more like peat moss or something to space some of the soil out. Because a lot of it's like really rich. But it's also very hard and dense. And it gets sort of... seems very heavy in like clay and organic matter, so when it dries out it sort of constricts, and I think it might be giving the roots of the plants a hard time. So I'd like to mix some sand in with some of it, especially for the potatoes and the root vegetables and stuff, you don't want them constricted by the soil because then they come out all wonky shaped. And we want our rutabagas to be nice and round, and we want our radishes to be nice and big, and we don't want our carrots choked or our potatoes crushed. So you put them in like really loosely packed, sort of loamy or very sandy soil, and that actually helps their roots be able to expand properly. So long as like the nutritional value of the soil is also there. So I'm super excited about getting to garden. I got some chicken wire. I'm probably gonna have to get more. I can get plant spray that's just like basically capsaicin to keep the animals off of the plants by making them spicy boys. But once the hot peppers I'm growing start to come in, I'd actually just like to make my own. Just, you know, volatile plant compounds in a spray bottle with water. Just soak those hot peppers in there raw and spray the plants with them. So, you know, you might need to rinse off the plants before eating them. Otherwise, they'll be a little spicy. But it'll also keep the rabbits and the deer from eating them. Because the rabbits and the deer won't want things that are laced with Happy Nero. It's just, we don't mind things laced with hot peppers like habaneros or chipotle peppers, but I imagine that if a deer or a rabbit got a taste of that, they'd be like, these are nope plants, and I am noping on out of here. So, that's the plan. I don't want to do anything to actually harm any animal. I'd like to feed them and be their friend. And I don't want to put any kind of chemicals on the plants. At least. Not the kind I wouldn't otherwise be eating. There we go. And that's those bricks. All shinied up. Sorry, I'll give you a close up here if I can. Yeah. Could this just like, yeah, focus. Look at those brick boys. Yeah. That's like my favorite side of the foundation. You have the front of the house. Bricks are a little shiny, but they're not like too shiny. They probably look much shinier on camera. This side. You see there's a little problem with the foundation over here. And its bottom slices missing either somewhere in that box or elsewhere. If I find it, I'll glue it back on, but otherwise I have to re-sculpt it. See if we can get this to focus. Yeah! Look at it. If it stops freezing. Look at that. I'll just turn this very slowly and give you a good close up of this side because I like this side. Yeah. Yeah, there's bricks with character, my good dudes. Excellent. I had the nail polish off of my finger. I would not recommend that. Do as I say, not as I do. Don't apply varnish with ungloved fingertips. But yeah. This looks good. This looks like it's a little long. And like the edges are only slightly wonky. And I'm hoping it doesn't. Here. I'm gonna move this. Yeah. Probably gonna also change my category for a hot second. Back to just chatting. So So I feel like, I feel like I keep starting sentences and not finishing them because that's where my capacity to think is at right now. That's fun. I'm gonna try taking down this one corner from either side. It's really extra. Not so much on the face that we wanted, but on the rest of the mold in behind it. Ooh, the sand that I put in here to make it good for the grout might be a little much to try to sand tidily on the sandpaper. Just gonna very gently and very carefully rub that on there. Just enough to knock down the back of the paving stone. The face, like I said, is pretty good, but we're just gonna try to knock down the back a bit. Sorry. But I have been playing with camera angles, trying to get that doing better for you guys. I have that book where I have a log of upcoming projects. Need this side. And this last side. That's so close. I feel like that's really close. It's just slightly crooked. Trying to adjust the angles of these. I didn't quite measure it when I was making it, and the pour wasn't perfect, so I'm gonna keep. Toying around with the edges of this. Focus, yet twit. I'm just gonna wait here until you focus on this beautiful little hexagon. So we can see the lovely organic texture and variance and character that it has. I know you can do this. I believe in you.